right to their immediate attention. It is not as sexy or as exciting as the Iranian arms deal, but it is in the long term and more importantly, American people and the survival of our former government. I would also urge you and your European friends to work for the repeal of your own country, and let the task would be absolutely no doubt. I regret that on several occasions when I was a member of the legislature that I voted for the death penalty. As a result of what has happened to me, in this case, I am convinced that innocent people have been found guilty and have been executed. And 2 weeks ago, I saw 16 minutes of discussion in a further case in Philadelphia, where the person was convicted of murder and was on death row, and then was finally discovered he did not commit the threat of murder. Around the turn of the century, the much-raging journalist Lincoln Stephens authored the book The Shame of the Cities. His book was largely responsible for much needed improvement in the living conditions and working conditions of the slum dwellers in America's cities. Lincoln Stephens journalistic dwellers left, quote, to see the shameful facts, spread out along their chains, but not going for a civic shamelessness and such fire to American crime, close quote. Perhaps what America needs most now is another Lincoln Stephens, an author who writes a best-selling book entitled The Shame of Our Lives. As my political career draws to a close, I want to thank the people who made it possible the union of good people of Crawford County, who in 1964 had the faith to elect a 24-year-old as a native member of the General Assembly, and then the people of Crawford, Mercer, and Eastern Area Counties, who in 1970 elected me to the state senate, right to the voters of Pennsylvania, who elected me first in 1980, and in 1984 saw foolish annual CPI allegations and re-elected me by a margin of 310,000 votes. I want to participate successfully in 8 primary elections, 8 general elections, and 1 election for delegates to the Republican National Convention, which was my personal bicentennial project. And I'm on the last page now, and I don't have enough to pass out, but please, I'll leave this here, and you can make copies for the people who are supposed to keep up the copies here right now. I thank the good Lord for giving me 47 years of exciting challenges, stimulating experiences, many happy occasions, and most of all, the finest life and children any man could ever design. Now my life has changed for no apparent reason. People who call on writers, press, readers, and poor helpers. They know I'm innocent and want their help. But in this nation, the world's greatest democracy, there is nothing they can do to prevent me from being punished for a crime they know I did not commit. Some rule of thumb have said that I'm a modern-day Joe. Judge Muir has also noted for his medieval sentences. I face a maximum sentence of 55 years in prison and a $300,000 fine for being innocent. Judge Muir has already told the press that he, quote, felt invigorated when we were found guilty, and he plans to imprison me as a return to other public officials. But it wouldn't be a return because every public official who knows me knows that I am innocent, that when we are given a punishment because I've done nothing wrong. Since I'm a victim of political persecution, my prison would simply be an American gulag. I ask those who believe in me to continue to extend friendship and care to my family, to work untiringly for the creation of a true justice system here in the United States, and to press on with the efforts to vindicate me, so that my family and their future families are not tainted by this injustice that has been perpetrated on me. We were confident that right and truth would prevail, and I would be acquitted, and we would devote the rest of our lives working to create a justice system here in the United States. The guilty verdict has strengthened that result. But as we discuss our plans to expose the work of our legal system, people have said, well thought of, no one cares, you're the fools, 60 Minutes, 2020, the American Civil Liberties Union, Jack Anderson, and others have been publicizing cases like yours for years, and it doesn't bother me. At this point in time, well, Bob Polsky here. Bob. Where's Ray? Can you come up here? Where's Scott Johnson? Can you come up, Don? Where are you?
I'm not here.
Okay. Just hang on to that light for the moment. Don, that's supposed to be the world. So don't make it a joy.